tearing into the old Granada axle here. See what it'll come up with. I feel like there's a whole lot of slop in it. See how messy it is. Tag on there. Let me get you to read that. It's WER. Let's see if I can read it. WER-AC. Looks like a 7ED. WER part's an important part, I think. Alright, let's see how bad this looks. Don't look too bad. But I don't know. Well, this came out of a Granada with a V8 in it. So hopefully it can handle that V8 back there. Slight tear in the gasket. It's okay, we got a new one. No major grind. Actually, not too bad. Round and round she goes. Alright, so probably should say on these gears somewhere to see some words. Of course, I have dog hair on it already. Ford I can't see. Put this light up here that's blinding me. Oh, I just don't like that light for some reason. Okay. All you younger guys and gals out there, once you hit 40, things start going downhill and you can't see stuff like this. So, D7AW, so that would be 77. 4210AA 71. No, it says 7 or a 1. Hard to tell. Must be 77. 24. Okay. 247. That's what it was. 8.7, I think. MIP. 247. Really wish it wasn't that fast of a ratio. Yeah, I'd like to change that. I just don't think I got the change to do it. Can you spare some change? And stick it back up here along with the light. Yellow paint in there. Check this out. Still yellow paint. Huh. So, this thing is as old as I am. It just seems a little remarkable to me. I am by no means an axle expert, but this 8-inch does not have a removable housing or curb member. But I'm assuming I can buy the same ring and pinion. I just have to put it in there and do the correct adjustment on the crush seat. That's the thing, you can't just swap gears as easily, so I kind of only want to do it once. So, which means I gotta kind of find the money to buy some gears. I think it's around $500. Everything goes up $3 a day in hourlies. I think that's it for tonight. I need to do more research. Alright, so this is the 8.7. We just got the undercoating put on there. Craigslist rebuild. Nothing too fancy. Now, I originally was thinking this was an 8-inch, so that's what I ordered for parts. I got some brake parts here, wheel cylinders, spring kit, and then I bought seals. Now, I think I'm gonna get lucky and be able to use these seals on this axle from what I've been able to find online, which was not easy. 3604 is a pinion seal, and these are the wheel end seals. So, I guess we are gonna pull the axles out and see what we can do here. Kind of wish I could get some better gears in here, but I think I probably won't be able to get the crush sleeve to reset the pinion. All that junk. So we're just gonna let it as is. The old 247 gears. Hell, it'll get good gas mileage as a four cylinder until the V8 comes around. So let's get busy. Try and get you in a little closer this time. Got my microphone over here. Try to make it so you can hear a little better. The pellet stove is pretty noisy, so that is what it is when you live in Wisconsin. So I gotta adjust this light down a little bit. It's making me go a little crazy. Blinding me. All right, what did I do with my ratchet? A little warmer out there today. It's actually double digit temperatures instead of single, so that's nice. Okay, so there's some heavy wear on this. This is all metal fragments here, peened over off the edge. Kind of bad. It's only on one side. Wow, kind of sharp. Okay. So we have that out. So now there's a gear. Oh, one fell down. This one was on the bottom, the opposite side. Which, that one did not have the wear marks. Just over here. The other one fell inside. Yep. There's some definite scalding or bowings or whatever on the inside of this one. Can do anything about that. All right, so now we got to get them C-clips out. And from my readings on the internet, that knows very little about these things, somebody said that the C-clip is the only thing that is the same part number as 8.8. If we need a new one of those, we should be okay. Well, you gonna come out of there? So that looks okay-ish. Stamped with a PI. There's O-rings under there. It also has a PI on it. A little bit of a ding right there. Something hit that. Curious if I could fit an 8.8 spool in there. Not that I want to spend $50 on this thing. Well, actually, I think it was more like $80. I can't remember.
messed up his seal. Alright, so we gotta pull this old seal out. We're not gonna do anything with the bearings, and we're just gonna hope they're good. Did I use this? Probably not the right tool. That's what I got. Brakes on my cart here. Oh, yeah. Got the microphone way down here. How's that? That's probably better. Alright, that's not working so good. What do you think, dog, huh? What should I do? There she be. Stopping. Sure, if that's all the way in. Socket's a little too big. I'm gonna call it good. All right, we'll get turned around for round two. Got all the C-clips on. So now, we gotta take care of this pin. Not quite the mess on there. It's a bastard file. That is the actual name of it. Hey. That's some pretty tough stuff. So we're gonna try to use a chisel, pry up these flakes. Yeah. You can see that. There's some flakes there. Well, I might have to do a grinder. Alright, we're gonna try this old flapper wheel. It's pretty well beat down. You need a Cheeto? You want a Cheeto? You need a Cheeto? Alright, so that turned out pretty good. There's a little digger on this side, and the real bad stuff was on this side, so we got that taken off. And that doesn't fix any of this wear. So I don't know. That might just have to be the way it is. That was this gear, I think. So that would be like this. Still goes pretty smooth. Well, it is what it is, as my old employer would say. It means it costs too much money to do it right. So, I'm gonna get these gears back in. Okay, it's a new day. We're gonna try to take care of the old pinion seal here. I've already taken off the yoke. I soaked it in some gasoline to get all the gunk off of it. It's looking pretty good. It could probably get scrubbed off one more time. But we're gonna try using an old chisel and a hammer, ball peen hammer. I already kind of started working on the lip of this seal here. We're gonna see if we can pop this out of here without causing too much damage. Just because I am not sure if the new one is right. And this is an ultra low budget Fire Pinto production. Okay. I need a thicker something. Unfortunately, all my chisels are put away in a place that I can't get to them. Oh yeah. So this has a number on it. Well, that hammer's gone for good. Okay. In USA, that's a plus. And it says 18190. See a brand name on it. All right, found my old tube of Ultra Blue Permatex.
I don't know. I think I've seen people use pipe dope plumbing on here. I don't understand how that works when it's not a thread, it's a spline. We're gonna do this. Don't want any on the seal itself. All right, good enough. A little lube on here. Loop goes on the sealed surface of the rubber seal. But we don't want it on the spline surface. Go. Well, it looks like I could probably get more RTV in there. Let's get the other. Kind of see the little depression that the spline has, so I could fill that area up with a little bit of RTV. Or I'm just making a big mess, one of the two. get in there. Probably making a big mistake here because I don't have the torque wrench to do the nut right now. So I gotta get it down in there. But also, I gotta clean off the thread area so it doesn't interfere with that nut torque setting. Well, what's going on now? Why is it jerking like that? Yeah, it's because I don't have the nut on there. Silicone is so messy. So it's time to start on the brake. This is pretty well corroded here. Maybe we'll shine that up a little bit. See, but my high quality Ford Pinto production. This is my microphone mount that is to the rafters with a clamp. Good stuff.
Okay, so I had to do some shopping. I ended up getting a pair of these sets. It's the brake adjuster. I only have one from the old set, so there was one side that was kind of falling apart when I bought the axle and got damaged in the junkyard somehow, so got two of those kits and had to go find an inch pound torque wrench. That was very difficult in the stores that were around. If they had an inch pound one, it was actually a foot pound one that had an inch pound reading on it, and it wouldn't do smaller inch pounds. So I got this one at O'Reilly's, a performance tool, and I need to do between 6 and 8 foot pounds to set this preload on here. And this one, it's like it'll barely do it. It goes from 0 to 10 real quick. That's what we got. So let's do it. And this was the cheapest one in town. This is like $31, I think. And the only one capable of doing it. So, do it. And it actually reads on zero. I saw a lot of them that didn't do that. But it is very basic. Oh, and it's only quarter inch drive. yeah. Let's see what kind of adaptation I can do there. This one here, not breaking it. I hit the microphone again. Okay, this is a 11/16. Yeah, I think we're closer to the 6 end of the spectrum, but I'd say we're in there. If you sped up a little bit, it got a little bit higher. I don't know. It's an old piece of crap. Alright, so we're gonna attempt putting the brake shoes on. I believe I got this from Rock Auto, and it was like heavily discounted. Look at how old this box is. Sure Grip Premium Asbestos. Ooh, asbestos. Don't know why they were discounted. Brake Parts Incorporated, McHenry, Illinois. Rebestos Products Company, registered trademark license to Brake Parts. Mm-hmm. Well, they're relined brake shoes. With asbestos. They work. Can't remember the last time I ever did brake shoes. It's been a long time. But it was probably on a Pinto wagon, so. These all look the same. We got brake shoes, and we got spring kit. So, oh, this is gonna be tough. Two of them have to get. Well, I guess we really can't get very far if we don't have those parts yet. Gotta wait for them to dry. See if I can find a picture that I took. I know how to put this crap back together. Uh-oh. Not seeing it. That's bad. Well, I don't know. Hopefully I saved it on a computer somewhere. This one is, I don't know. I can't tell which one's right or left. Dang. Okay. Had a little break. Cleared my head a little bit. Figured out which one's right and left. They're stamped right on the metal parts. So that's left. And after reading through how many different vehicles this brake setup is on, I found my old truck Haynes manual. Let's see if we got any brake details in here. Look at that. Classic.
thing is showing its age. Okay, brakes, brakes, brakes. Chapter 9. Turn pages in a book or something. Okay, drum brakes. We got torque specs. Okay. That's probably where we have to start. Installing parking brake actuating lever onto new shoes. Which are still drying. Okay, what was I looking for? Front of vehicle. Parking brake lever goes on the back one. Have one up here. Lightly coat shoe guide pads on the backing plate with high temperature brake grease. Must be these flat spots here. I'm gonna buzz them real quick. That worked, but that sure felt like I could have got hurt doing that. Am I done? Oh shit, what's this for? See any part like that. I think that's it. I wonder if that spring washer is supposed to go in there somewhere, but there's no room for nothing like that. See if these babies fit. It's good to me. Just need my wheel studs. Get in there and do some brake clean. All right, well, that's it for this side. I need a break before I go mad.